Though it may seem that the world is dividing between these clean energies, it's not either slash or. Often, when there are discussions about hydrogen fuel cells or battery electric engines, the conversation will focus on which one is the best clean energy option to power our future. Increasingly, experts are agreeing that it won't be one or the other, and that it is likely that they will not be the only clean power options as we move forward in the battle against climate change. There are advantages to both types of carbon emission-free power, and they each have their place. Proponents of each technology have been vocal in spotlighting the benefits that they have to provide. Often, they will compare battery electric to hydrogen fuel cell performances, particularly when it comes to vehicles. However, experts are now coming to the conclusion that it's not really a matter of deciding which technology will win out and which will disappear. Instead, each form of clean power will find its place, as each has strengths in their own areas. It's true that battery electric passenger vehicles have taken a tremendous head start over hydrogen cars, but that doesn't mean there isn't a place for both. Geography, use, cost, climate, and other factors all play a role in determining which option is best suited. Even in passenger vehicles, hydrogen fuel cars are expected to play a supporting role in coming years. According to Toyota's Fuel Cell Integration Group Senior Engineering Manager Jackie Birdsall and McKinsey & Company Senior Partner Bernhide, as zero-carbon transportation continues to advance, it is likely that fuel cell vehicles and electric cars will play complementary roles to each other. They discussed this subject while taking part in an online panel hosted by Automotive News. "I think we will see in the next year that we will need both technologies," explained Hid. The interesting part is that it's not only dependent on the propulsion technology of the powertrain, but it also has to do with the infrastructure. And we will see that two infrastructures will be cheaper to society than if we just do all electric infrastructure. "Hydrogen and fuel cell electric vehicles are complementary," said Birdsall in agreement, stating that the vehicle decarbonization transition cannot be accomplished through a single technology. "There's two different use cases. Our job is to give these zero-emission technologies, to make them available to the customer, and then the customer can choose the application or the powertrain that best suits their lifestyle and that best suits their fleet's needs." About the future of electric and hydrogen fuel vehicles, Birdsall went on to add that, "We need to invest in the infrastructure equally for both battery electric and for fuel cell electric vehicles, so that they can both succeed and both be available, because in reality, we're going to need both if we are going to really achieve our decarbonization goals." Thank you for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe and grab our free H2 ebook for more updates. Also, leave us a comment and let your thoughts be heard.